I'm reading today from the Gospel according to St. Mark, the 10th chapter, verse 46, reading as follows in Jesus' name. And they came to Jericho, and he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people. Blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And when the blind man heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out, saying, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace, but he cried the more a great deal, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, be of good comfort, rise, he calleth thee. And he casting away his garment, his beggar's garment, he threw away this garment that identified him as a blind beggar. He threw away his tin cup, and casting away his garments, he arose and came to Jesus. And Jesus answered and said unto him, What wilt thou that I should do unto thee? The blind man said unto him, Lord, that I might receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, go thy way. Thy faith hath made thee whole. And immediately, he received his sight and followed Jesus in the way. Here's a picture of a world that's blind, a world that doesn't know God, a world sitting by the highway side, begging for the crumbs that the world gives. What can the world give? Nothing but heartache, but trouble, but difficulty, but pain. And the Bible says Jesus declared the thief, the devil, the god of this world, the god of this world, the prince of the power of the air, he operates in death. Jesus said the devil, the thief, has come for three reasons only: to steal, kill, and to destroy. But I am come that you might have life, and you might have it more abundantly. A picture of a lost world sitting by the highway side, begging for a few crumbs. And then Jesus comes by. And someone says, did you know that it's the prophet from Galilee? Did you know that it's the Son of God? Did you know it's the Christ, the Messiah? Jesus, the Son of David, is passing by. And immediately he realizes in his weakness, in his poverty, and in his blindness, he cries out, oh, Jesus, thou Son of David. He identifies him as the Son of God, the God-man, the Messiah. And he cries out, and others say, don't do it. Don't bother him. He has no time for you. You're a tramp. Don't bother him. But he keeps on crying. And all of a sudden, Jesus stops. And all the hubbub, and all the noise, Jesus heard the cry. It doesn't matter what people say around you, he'll still hear your cry. People have been sitting in beer parlors and in lounges, cocktail lounges, and God has spoken and say, leave this place. God can speak to you wherever you are right now. In your sin, he can speak to you. And if you will say yes, and Jesus stopped and he said, call him. Call the blind man. And they call him, and he throws away his beggar's garment. He's not going to need that anymore. God's going to heal him. He throws away his beggar's garment. And Jesus says, what would you like? He said, I would like you to heal me. I'd like you to be able to see. And Jesus touches him and makes him well. Makes him well. And Jesus Christ says, be well. He says, thy faith hath made thee whole. Faith in the Father, faith in the Son, faith in the Holy Ghost, these three are one. Demons will tremble, sinners awake. Faith in Christ Jesus will anything shake. So have faith in God, my friend. I'm Pastor Max Solbrekken. You can come to the church, the little church on Highway 623, just south of New Sarepta. It's called the House of Prayer. Every Sunday at 11, potluck after the service. Bring something, whatever you like. Wednesday is a night of hearing God's word. It's a Bible seminar every Wednesday at 7. And I'll be there. God bless you.